evening and welcome to high school basketball on SJSportsTalk.com. My name's Tony Blum along with George McNally, and George is making his analyst color person debut with us, and we're really pleased to have him. Of course, longtime coach of Egg Harbor Township, and great to have you with us.
Thanks, Tony. Thanks. Exciting to be here. Nice to see an Olympic Conference game where I don't have to worry about who I'm scouting and who I'm trying to guard the next time around.
Here we have two teams, though, who are both very, very good teams. One, 11-0, that's Shawnee, and 8-2 is Camden Catholic. So let's take a look, first of all, at Shawnee. As we said, they are 11-0, coached by someone that pretty much is very well known to all of South Jersey. He's been there a long time, very successful coach, and Joe Kessler. I talked to him, and he said, hey, look, on offense, we want to move the ball. We're very unselfish. We get good shots. And 8 to 10 shots each game are gotten by the starters. So it's very, very well balanced on offense. On defense, they play man-to-man. They play a help defense. And on defense, they want to help each other out. So that's what we need to do. And we also, number one, have got to keep Camden Catholic off the boards because they're very strong inside. On offense, they want to move the ball versus that matchup zone. They said, we've seen a matchup zone this season, and we think we can get good shots off that matchup zone, because one thing, and I don't have to tell you, but it's very difficult to prepare for a matchup zone as well as the offense they run, which is kind of a motion offense, that old Princeton type of offense. You don't see it very often, so, you know, at times it can be problematic, but he felt pretty confident.
Yeah, I know in the past, Shawnee's been very difficult to defend with their screening and with their movement. And now with the matchup from Camden Catholic, it'll be interesting because you don't really screen away from the ball against the matchup because the defense switches naturally and it's easy to make a cover. Maybe some more ball screens. It's interesting to hear that Camden Catholic is strong on the boards, because if I were watching two teams warm up, I would have guessed the other way around. So there's no question this will be interesting. And Shawnee's definitely known for their man-to-man. They're going to stay in front of you. They're going to force you to hit things from the perimeter. And you're not going to get many second shots, that's for sure.
We're going to take a look at Camden Catholic in just a moment. Just want to mention that Next Level Aquatics in Voorhees has a simple vision to become the comprehensive aquatics facility where individuals of all ages, including families and athletes, can learn to participate in swimming and all physical fitness activities with confidence and skills. Next Level Aquatics is the home South Jersey Aquatic Club and offers swim lessons at a physical therapy pool. They are programmed for every fitness level: physical therapy, master swimming, aqua boot camp, and coming soon, stand-up paddleboard yoga. Visit nextlevelaquatics.com for more information. And remember, there are two X's in Next. They're at 333 Preston Avenue in Voorhees. Next Level Aquatics. Both teams warming up. To our right is Shawnee, the Renegades, and the Irish to our left. Taking a look at Camden Catholic, coached by Matt Crawford, son of longtime and very successful coach Jim Crawford. They will run the motion offense, not necessarily all the time. They want to look to get the best shot possible. Their two leading scorers are Baba Ajike and Dominic Dunn. They're both 6'5", so that may be what Coach Kessler is talking about. They run the matchup zone on defense. And one thing about that matchup defense, which is very similar to Atlantic City, although they don't run the matchup defense, is both coaches say it's not where exactly we want it to be, but as the season goes along, it gets better. On offense, they want to be patient. He says that Shawnee kind of plays a packed-in defense, and that allows them to reset their offense if the first look is not there. They want to make good passes, play together, and they have eight players, he said, who can hit threes. That makes it tough. On offense, the key is to be patient, no forced shots. And on defense, they want to talk and communicate to each other and get out on the shooter. Interesting.
Yeah, I'm not surprised that Camden Catholic shoots threes. Most teams come out and do layups as they come out of the locker room. Camden Catholic lined up at that three-point line and just let them go. So that's not a big shock. Camden Catholic, first place in their division. Shawnee, first place in theirs. The Olympic Conference is good basketball. This should be a good game.
No question about it. And also Shawnee on the Prime Events top teams in South Jersey. Shawnee ranked number 8 at 11-0. course, they are in South Jersey Group 4. Camden Catholic, 8-2. Non-public A is their category. And, of course, when I say South Jersey, you may say, well, what's the Patrick School Roseville Catholic doing in South Jersey? But that's the way the state of New Jersey classifies teams. They start at the very top of New Jersey geographically and work their way down. And once they reach a certain level of schools in that particular category, then they go to the next and the next. And that's why the Patrick School at 9-3 and Roseville Catholic at 9-3, both in non-public B, are rated number one and number two. But as you just mentioned to me a few minutes ago, Camden Catholic has to be pretty proud and pretty excited coming off that win over Camden.
Yeah, they have, if you look on paper, they have better wins than Shawnee does, and Shawnee's the higher rated team. Not only beat Camden, they also beat Bishop Eustis. So those are two good wins. Shawnee has beaten Cherokee and Eastern. Coach Ketcher said, though, the toughest part of their schedule is yet to come, starting tonight.
All right, so we're going to be set for the opening tip-off in just a moment, but first I want to tell you about Mutual of Omaha. You know that insurance can be a very complicated thing, right? Well, how much do you need? What kind is best? At Mutual of Omaha, they simplify the process. Mutual of Omaha can help you decide on the best life insurance or Medicare supplement insurance for your situation. They can also help with disability insurance, online banking, and retirement plans. Contact the professionals at Mutual of Omaha. They're at 9000 Lincoln Drive East in Marlton. Can be reached at 856-988-7771. Mutual of Omaha. Right now, from Camden Catholic, home of the Irish, playing of our national anthem. National anthem here from Camden Catholic. Nice facility here. Green and white decor and a nice floor. Nice.
Yeah, and it should be a good crowd. They're starting to fill in with two first place teams in the division Olympic Conference. We should have a heck of a game.
Introductions of players first for the visiting Shawnee Renegades. They will start Pat Kernan, 6'3 sophomore. Devon Robinson, 6'4 junior. Sean Hine, a 6'4 junior. Dean Knoll, a 6'1 junior. And Dylan DeVenny, who is a 6'6 junior. Renegades, as we mentioned, come in at 11-0 on the season. Now for Camden Catholic, the Irish, coached by Matt Crawford, and we can see his father across the way, also on the bench. Babatunde Ajike, a 6'5 sophomore. By the way, throughout the broadcast, we're going to refer to him as Baba Ajike, if that's okay with you. That's what everybody calls him, so we will too. Dominic Dunn, a 6'5 junior. Ian McCarthy, a 6'2 senior. Kyle Cooney, a 5'10 senior, and Nazir Streeter, who is a 5'10 senior. So all of the starters for Shawnee, Georgia, are all over 6 feet, even the guards, so a little bit of height advantage there, and that could come into play.
Yeah, that's what I was saying when I heard that Camden Catholic gets to the boards. I would think Shawnee would have that advantage there tonight. There is a bigger kid sitting on Camden Catholic's bench in street clothes. We don't have a number on him. It looks like he could have helped in that too, but it'll be interesting because there's no question Shawnee likes to shoot the ball, and Camden Catholic, from what we said, does too, so there might be a lot of long rebounds too to set up a little pace of play.
So just about set. Shawnee in their navy blues with light blue and white trim, and Camden Catholic in their white uniforms with green trim. Robinson will jump it up against the GK.
Both teams have a defensive lineman for the tap.
Tip control by Shawnee, taken by Hine. Right side throws for Noel, holding the basketball. Center court throws for Hine. High over his head, steps to his right now, left sideline for Noel. Down low pass for Robinson, outside for Koenig. Right sideline, throws for Hine, holds it high over the head, outside for Kernan. Deals left sideline for Noel. Steps to his right, now retreats. Right baseline, he finds Hine. Outside, flips for Noel. Up high goes for Devaney, underneath to the cutting Robinson for the reverse that is good.
Fairness, it's great movement off the ball from Shawnee. They're going to have to work real hard offensively. Sometimes on offense against a matchup is harder than man.
Right sideline, it's Streeter, moves it to center court, sends left side for Cooney. Cooney puts on the floor, circling to his right. Deals left sideline for the long range jump by McCarthy that is short, and the rebound is taken off by Noel. Outside for the long range jump, that is good!
Sometimes the trail three is the hardest thing to defend.
Hine connects from deep. Streeter moves it across, 5-0. Renegades out of the gate quickly, underneath to the cutter, but it's poked away, looking to hit Streeter, cutting to the bucket, poked away though by Devaney, and out of bounds, last touch by Shawnee. So Noel to trigger, check that. Streeter to trigger, it comes to Dunn, return center court for Streeter. Deals right sideline for McCarthy. Outside for Dunn, left side for a GK. Holding it high over the head, snaps right sideline. Loose for the long range jump to Streeter. Skying for the rebound as Robinson gives it off to Noel. Moves it across with a right hand dribble. One hops up high for Robinson. Left side line it goes for Kernan. Up high again for Robinson. Left hand corner for Devaney, outside. He finds Kernan, left-hand corner for the jumper by Noel. It is no good. Rebound is taken off by Robinson. Looks to feed underneath to the cutter. That was Hine, but intercepted and taken off by Streeter. Left-hand corner for McCarthy, outside. He finds Streeter, leaves it for Cooney. Fires up high for Dunn. Leaves it for Cooney, looking to work off the pick from Dunn. Watch by Noel, steps to his right, one hops right-hand corner for Streeter. Circling to his left, and I think we're going to get a moving pick on Dunn.
Yeah, it's a shame they had the lane open to the ball handler. Just need to be a little bit more patient and set up that screen, allowing his big to get there instead of having the offensive foul.
So off the turnover, basketball in the hands of Noel as he moves it across in deliberate fashion. Head of the key, veers to his right. Cut off, sends right-hand corner for McCarthy. Check that, Hine, pardon me. Outside for Robinson, leaves it for Noel. Deals right side for Devaney. Holds it high over the head. One hops right side for Noel. Right-hand corner for Hine. Down low Robinson. Here's the cutter, Noel, for the reverse. That is good. Going left hand there.
Those are great possessions by Shawnee. But I will say that the matchup zone sometimes has more effectiveness as the game goes on because there's a lot of movement needed for the offensive team.
Outside, Dunn. Down low, Ajike backing his way for the floater that is no good, in and out. Robinson with the rebound.
It's a good possession there, a good position. He just floated a little bit on the release. I think that's something they might want to try and do a little bit more of.
Here's Noel, veering right off the pick from Robinson. Outside for Robinson. Giving chase is Cooney. Left side for DeVente. Deep in the left-hand corner. Hine for the side jump. That is good for three. And Camden Catholic wants to talk it over. As Hine already with 8 points, a couple of threes, and Camden Catholic down big early, 10 to nothing.
Well, I got to say, I'm not surprised that Shawnee's getting the shots they're getting. Coach Kessler's teams are known for moving the ball and making the extra pass, and Hines has his feet set, and he's straightening up, and he looks like he's a pretty good shooter right now.
I'd say right now paying big dividends. Well, it's known all over the Delaware Valley. Johnson's Popcorn on the Ocean City Boardwalk, specializing in their delicious caramel corn. Get Johnson's Popcorn in individual servings all the way up to 3.5-gallon tins. Look for them in your favorite food market or party store. Johnson's Popcorn, 1368 Boardwalk in Ocean City. Phone 800-842-2676 and have your popcorn shipped to you. They're online at johnsonspopcorn.com. Johnson's Popcorn since 1940. So here's Cooney moving it out of the backcourt, left side. Met by Noel, left-hand corner. Loose is McCarthy for the jumper, but it's no good, and DeVente snares the rebound with great position.
Yeah, did a nice job boxing out there.
Here's Noel. Noel cut off to DeVente outside, up high for Robinson. Robinson, pump fake, does not shoot to DeVente. DeVente called for steps as he looks to fire cross-court.
Looks like Camden Catholic may have switched a man there, following a couple cutters through, so I'd like to see next possession.
10-zip with 3:38 left in this opening quarter. Shawnee on top. Streeter leaves it for McCarthy. Cross court for Cooney. Left side of the circle. Holds it high over the head. One hops right side for Ajike. Outside for Dunn. One hops right side for Streeter. Holds up the dribble, looking to direct traffic. Look to leave it for Cooney. Now loose on the floor. Dunn rescues. Cross-court pass deep in the left-hand corner. The drive by Dunn, no good, but he is fouled on the play. That pass actually by McCarthy, pardon me.
Well, the last couple possessions by Camden Catholic much better. They had a nice little flex action there for a while. Got the Shawnee all stretched out. Were able to penetrate baseline. The ball screen was a good idea, the one possession with the foul. And then the post entry is a good idea, too. So maybe they just got to get over a little bit of the jitters here early.
Dunn with the first. In and out. Dunn a 6'5 junior. We'll get one more. The second is perfect. So Camden Catholic with just over 3 minutes left in the first quarter on the board. Veering to his right is Kernan. Right-hand corner. He finds Hine up high for Robinson. Here's Kernan circling to his left to DeVente. Up high, Robinson with a step down the lane for the floater that is good.
That's nicely done. He turned and face, showed the ball, and had a nice easy finish.
Yeah, made it look easy on that one. Streeter out of the backcourt. 12-1 now. Right sideline for Cooney. Played tightly by Noel outside. Dunn loose for the jumper that is off the back of the rim. Rebound fought for. Still loose on the floor and a whistle. Last touched. They say by Shawnee.
Camden Catholic's getting some good shots. They need to knock down a couple here though. Give him some confidence.
Inbounding is Cooney. Lobs down low for Ajike and a foul going to be called for a push.
And I think that's a good plan of attack, getting Ajike the ball. He's young, and Devaney's got maybe a little bit more bulk on him, but now Devaney's out of the game. I wouldn't be surprised if we get the ball inside to Ajike here a couple times.
Fundner comes in to replace him. Streeter switching hands on the dribble. Left-hand corner for Dunn, looking to drive the baseline, but knocks it off. Defender for Shawnee, sorry.
Shawnee's help defense is tremendous.
Inbound pass done. Loose for the jump. That is no good. They have been struggling from the outside in the early going. And rebound tipped out of bounds. Last touch by Shawnee.
These seem to be the shots that Coach Crawford wants. They just need to get a couple to go.
Inbound pass to Streeter. Approaching 2 minutes left in the first. Veers right off the pick from Dunn with a step down the lane. Too much on the shot. Overshoots everything. Rebound taken off by Knoll. Right-hand corner goes for Hine for the pull-up. Short. And the rebound taken off by McCarthy.
I'm just wondering if Camden Catholic doesn't want to try and push the pace a little too to maybe get an easy basket in transition.
Right sideline, Cooney cut off, having trouble finding someone. Now deals for Dunn, right-hand corner. Outside finds Cooney. 1:30 left in the quarter. Left-hand corner, a GK. Robinson gives him room. Down low. The flip for Dunn, short on the hook, and the rebound to Robinson.
Shawnee really takes away half the court from you on offense. They jump on an outside hip, and they force you to play on one side of the floor.
Knoll has it taken away on the pass. Here's Streeter. Misses the easy one on the floater. Nothing going their way in this early going. Right side, Fuchner for the turnaround, the spin, and the bucket.
You got to figure that basket needs to go. That's what they needed. They needed an easy one. That was their opportunity. So I think right now Camden Catholic is fighting themselves a little bit more than they're fighting Shawnee.
14-1 they're down with just over 51 seconds left in the first quarter. Well, Shoppies is even better online. You've probably visited their showroom at 1031 Shore Road in Linwood, but at Shoppie.com, you can select and design your own trophy or award and order it right there. Shoppies also has a complete line of gifts. Remember, you are not presenting the finest trophy unless you're presenting a Shoppie trophy. Phone 609-653-1684 for Shoppies since 1921. So Camden Catholic, a bit of a surprise. I mean, you figure coming off that win over Camden, that's pretty impressive. But here, just have not gotten the shots to go.
Yeah, they've gotten the shots they want. It just doesn't. Nothing's going in for it.
Here's Streeter. Left side for Cooney. One bounces down low for Dunn, backing his way. Turns for the left-hand hook again. Too strong. And the rebound comes down to Kernan to the forecourt. Right side. Finds Knoll. And a whistle. Knoll is called for steps.
Camden Catholic ran a nice little block-to-block screen the last time and got the entry into the post. Sometimes as a coach, you pull your hair out in these games. You're getting the shot you want. You're executing decently and just not getting anything to go.
Streeter to the forecourt. Met by Kernan. Snaps left side for Cooney. Head of the key for Dunn. Down low at GK. Baseline one-hander is no good. Rebound fought for. Loose on the floor. A couple of players crashing to the deck. That being McCarthy. One of them.
There's another inside opportunity for a GK.
Personal called against Shawnee, that being Fuchner. Inbound pass to McCarthy, left-hand corner, outside for Dunn. Puts on the floor. Dunn called for the offensive foul. So nothing going right here with just over 9 seconds left in quarter number one. They've managed a grand total of 1 point to Shawnee's 14, and you know they're going to play for one right here.
Yeah, historically Shawnee gets the shot they want in short clock situations. So
Knoll with a step. Knoll down the lane for the scoop that is no good. Rebound McCarthy. Three-quarter court. Chuck is no good. And that's it. We played one. And Shawnee racing out to a 13-point lead. They lead it 14-1. Well, there's a full line of brand-new cars available for rent at Just Four Wheels on the White Horse Pike in Galloway Township, Delsey Drive in Vineland, and on Washington Street in Cape May. They also have moving trucks, minivans, and 15-passenger vans. Be smart. Rent at Just Four Wheels, serving South Jersey for more than 35 years. In Galloway, Vineland, Berlin, Cape May, and Lakewood. We're open from 8:30 a.m. until 7 p.m. daily. Just Four Wheels, cars, trucks, and van rental. Well, Coach, you would be telling your team what? Just keep doing what you're doing. We've been getting the shots. We've just been ice cold. What are you telling them?
Actually, I just said, let's forget about that. Let's start over. Let's win this quarter. If they win this quarter, maybe get the score under 10 at halftime, they're right back in the game, because I'm telling you, matchup zones, as the game goes on, become tougher and tougher to attack.
We'll see how it plays out. Cooney. Inbounds to Streeter, returns to Cooney, works the left side. One hops up high for Streeter. Left side for Cooney. Returns the center court for Streeter. Outside. Dunn. Returns to Streeter. Swing it right sideline for Cooney. Cooney looking for help. Has it poked away. Able to recover, but now here it's stolen by Knoll. Great defense there. Knoll having trouble. Right side, though, finds Kernan. Down low, looks to return for Knoll, but it's picked off by Streeter.
I'm surprised they didn't try to push the ball a little bit there to get an easy opportunity.
Right sideline. Cooney outside of GK. Sends left-hand corner for McCarthy. McCarthy watched by Funkner. Outside lobs for Cooney. Left sideline for McCarthy. Down low to a GK. Outside. Cooney loose for three. It is no good. Continue to struggle from the outside. Does Camden Catholic.
And Shawnee's only giving you one shot. There's no second shots happening for Camden Catholic.
Well, he must have gotten the point across for the rebounding. They are only getting one shot. Deep in the left-hand corner for three. Yet again is Knoll, and he is sizzling.
Shawnee's not giving any open cracks here. Every opportunity they get, they're putting the ball in the basket, and they're making things real difficult down this end of the floor.
Center court. McCarthy. Right side of GK. Sends cross court for Dunn. Swing it right side for Streeter. Cross court pass for McCarthy. Backing his way. Here's the spin with a left hand scoop. It is good.
That's nicely done. They went back to their flex motion offense. They had some ball moving from side to side and make Shawnee defend all their movement. And they got their best opportunity of the game.
17-3 now. 6 minutes left till halftime. Knoll sends right side for Kernan. Center court Robinson. Right side for Hine. Right hand corner Robinson. Here's the cutter. Knoll, the left hand flip that is good. Great look and a great cut by Knoll.
This is everything Coach Kester could have wanted happened to be in this game. They're executing wonderfully. They're shooting the ball. They're defending. They're rebounding. He might want to bottle this one.
Left hand corner. Cooney, the jumper. Too strong. Rebound. Robinson nearly loses but able to rescue. And here's Knoll once again. 19-3 as Shawnee extending the lead. Right sideline finds Kernan.
Yeah, Camden Catholic and man now.
Throws left sideline for Knoll. Outside Kernan, and he got a foul. Yes, it is.
Illegal screen, I believe.
Yeah.
So here's the opening. Let's try and cut into this lead a little bit. I'd love to see the ball swing from side to side for Camden Catholic.
Elijah Nichols checks in. Nichols replacing McCarthy. Here's Streeter. Met by Kernan. Outside to Nichols. Nichols cuts in, gets some penetration, looks to scoop it because he thought he was going to walk, I think, and that didn't really pan out very well.
Yeah, that wasn't what they drew up, I can guarantee it out.
Left side, Fuchner, the long range pop is good.
I tell you what, I don't have the numbers, but they have to be shooting 80% from the field, Shawnee.
Three-pointer for Fuchner's come on. And it's now 22-3, a 19-point bulge for the Shawnee Renegades. Well, Gillian's Wonderland Pier, well, you know the rides aren't open, right? At 6th Street and the Boardwalk in Ocean City, but this is a real good time to get bargains for next summer. At Wonderland Pier, your tickets never expire. Bring your leftover tickets from this year to the park when it opens next spring. Gillian's Wonderland Pier, 6th and the Boardwalk at Ocean City. Visit them online at gillians.com. And at Stanton's Gallery on Asbury Avenue at downtown Gillian's. This is about as impressive a quarter and a half as you're going to see, right?
Yeah, oh, there's no question. And I wouldn't want to be Coach Crawford right now. He's sitting there probably turning his dad asking for any help that he can.
Moving it out of the backcourt is Cooney. One hops up high for Dunn. Left-hand corner, McCarthy was back in for three. That is good.
There's the execution that they had the entire game. Just got to put the ball in the basket.
Moving it across as Kernan operates left sideline. With a step, drives the baseline, cut off by Cooney. Here's Robinson, right-hand corner for the jumper. That is no good. That taken by Hine, and the rebound to Streeter. To the forecourt. Met by Kernan. Down the lane with a step that is rejected by Robinson. Loose on the floor. Picked up by Hine. Down court. He finds Nolo. Out jumps the defender down the lane for the scoop. That is good. And he was fouled on the play.
Looks like he took off with the wrong foot that time too. Controlled his body in the air and finished with the left hand. It's a nice outlet look from the other end too. And he was able to outfight the Camden Catholic kid for the ball.
Seemed to be playing with a lot of effort. I mean, an intense effort, Shawnee. I mean, they get the loose balls. They are able to pull it away. Noel gets up a little bit higher than a defender.
Effort, precision,
yeah,
confidence. This is about as good as it gets right now.
Free throw good. 25-6. A GK up high for McCoy, who's come on. Returns to a GK, left side for McCarthy. Center court. Finds Streeter. Deep in the right-hand corner for Cooney. Circles outside. McCoy now to the left sideline. Center court for Cooney. Looking to flip down low to a GK for the floater that is no good. Got the step but couldn't cash in, and the rebound comes off to Noel. Robbie Steffen also has checked in for Shawnee. Outside Robinson. Gives off to Noel. Noel cuts right, cut off outside for Robinson for three. That is no good. Rims out, and a GK skies to gather it.
You almost expected that to rim in the way things are going tonight.
Streeter, left side for Cooney. Veering to his right against Noel, deep in the right-hand corner. Here's Streeter. Spinning down the lane for the scoop. It is no good. Robinson snares the rebound. He outlets to Noel. Two on two. Outside for the long range. Hine jumper that is good. The trailer for the three.
One thing for sure. Hine can shoot the ball. I haven't heard of him yet this year, but he's one of the better shooters I've seen.
Downtown specialist. Down the lane is Cooney looking for the scoop that hits the underside of the rim. Rebound taken off by Noel. Noel. Cuts left. Outside. Kernan jumps. No good off the back of the rim. But here's Noel with the rebound. Sends outside. Long range jump by Hine. And he hits again from downtown.
Again, this is perfect Shawnee basketball. Ball movement, the execution, shooting the ball from the perimeter, keeping the ball on one side of the floor defensively. This is everything Shawnee teaches and has taught for years.
McCoy right side. Holds it high over the head. Cross court pass for Cooney. Watched by Noel. Deals right side for Streeter. Up high for McCarthy. Has a notion but does not shoot. Watched by Hine. Now puts on the floor. Retreats to center court. Sends right sideline for Streeter. Outside a GK to McCoy. Looks down low instead. Sends right side for McCarthy. Cross court pass for Streeter. Left sideline for McCoy for the jumper. That is off the back of the rim. No good. Rebound. Grabbed off by Kernan to the forecourt. Kernan looking to drive, and he just slips on the floor, and he traveled.
Right now, I might be looking for Hine wherever he's on the court. The kid's so hot right now.
You can see smoke coming off his hand. I'm telling you.
He's hoping this first half never ends, I think.
Robinson will take a seat. Coming on is Guaracino. For Shawnee. 6 foot senior. Streeter. Center court sends right side for McCarthy. Up high for a GK. Outside for Streeter. Cuts left. Underneath. He finds McCoy. Fires outside for McCarthy. Backing his way. Looking for a GK. And a GK loses control. And a little unhappy with the call. And probably with himself.
Yeah, I think he's a little frustrated, as I can imagine. He's a young kid, too. Fairly athletic, looks like he's got a good future in front of him, but definitely wants to make good decisions on the court.
55 seconds remaining till halftime. 31-6. You're not hearing that incorrectly. That's what the score is. Here's Knoll to the forecourt. Knoll down the lane. Underneath, he finds Guaracino. Knocked away and out of bounds. Last touch, though, by Shawnee.
It was a good opportunity. He made a good pump fake, but Cam McCaffrey went up and was able to challenge the play.
Center court. It's Streeter. Deals along the right sideline for Nichols. Looking to feed down low. And Ajike better watch himself because he's starting to do a little shoving and underneath there, and he might pick up a technical, so he's got to keep his composure.
Yeah, with 30 seconds left, he doesn't want to do anything that can cost him the rest of the game.
Up court. Here's Knoll behind the back, down the lane, looking to protect the ball with the body. Short flip is no good. Rebound comes down to Streeter, but it's stolen by Knoll. He's down the lane for the scoop. It is no good, and he is fouled on the play. This kid, Knoll, you can tell he's a tough, hard-nosed player.
Oh, no question. Defensively, he's caused the guard fits for Cam McCaffrey, but the catch he just made on that last outlet was tremendous. And then making the play to go back in and get the ball back. You're right, he's a tough kid, and I can see why Coach Kessler likes him on the floor.
First is good. Checking back in is Cooney. He'll replace Streeter. 32-6, Shawnee. Second is also good. 15 seconds remain till halftime.
See if Cam McCaffrey goes back to that side ball screen. They've opened things up.
Right-hand corner, the pass is stolen. Here's Knoll again with a step down the lane, and again, with just over 1 second left, he's able to draw the foul. So a chance for him to add two more points to his total and the team's as well.
Yeah, he almost looks out of control, but he's not. He's able to carry his speed and still make good decisions with it. I wouldn't mind having him play for me.
I'm sure. First bounces off the front of the rim and drops through. And that's what good shooters get. They get the roll. Second. Also good.
12 and he stole it again.
And the impact pass is stolen
by Knoll again. That kid, he's not letting anything get by. Between him and Hine, that's a heck of a first half right there.
So Shawnee on top, 35-6. They've just had an incredible first half of play. Next Level Aquatics in Voorhees has a simple vision to become the comprehensive aquatics facility where individuals of all ages, including families and athletes, can learn to participate in swimming and all physical fitness activities with confidence and skills. Next Level Aquatics, the home of the South Jersey Aquatic Club, offers swim lessons, a physical therapy pool. They are programmed for every fitness level. Physical therapy, master swimming, aqua boot camp, and coming soon, stand-up paddleboard yoga. Visit nextlevelaquatics.com for more information. Remember, there are two X's in Next. They're at 333 Preston Avenue in Voorhees. Next Level Aquatics. Well, we have a special halftime guest, so George, why don't you introduce him?
We have Coach Dave Pauley here from Philadelphia College of Sciences. Coach Pauley's had a lot of success recruiting some South Jersey players. This will be my first interview I've ever conducted. Thankfully, it's with Coach Pauley because I don't know if I even need to speak after this. Coach, welcome.
Thanks for having me, George. It's much easier on this side, isn't it, as
no
opposed
question.
To sitting on the bench?
No question. No question. What do you think about that first half?
One team's getting open shots. The other team's struggling to find any rhythm offensively and jumped out well, I thought. And, you know, once they started the ball reverse, they had even more open shots. It rains, it pours. You don't have somebody you can really go to kind of break that run. You can call timeouts. It's two types of coaches, humble coaches and those who will become humble. Right?
There you go. It's
yeah.
A good point there.
Yeah.
I thought they had some good possessions. They got Ejike the ball inside. They the one steal, and they were able to get in the open floor, but it just doesn't seem like it's their night.
Yeah, it's just, you know what, you have an open breakaway layup, and it goes in and out.
Yeah.
And you know what, those are the type of things that you have, unfortunately, in the game. The game is unforgiving, as you well know.
No, no question. And how about the way Hines shooting the ball? I haven't gotten a chance to see him much this year. Yeah. Only a junior.
Yeah, great standstill shooter. You know, they got him in the at the trail position. You know, he's running the floor behind the play. Quick pitch on the ball reversal. It's a good shot, man. He just caught it in rhythm and, you know, just let it fly. And then, you know, one, two, and it starts to add up, you know.
Yep.
And it's a mental thing. You know, he's feeling it. And again, I get back to the point, it's still wide open.
Yeah.
Wide open shots.
But it's funny you talk about that trail position. That's maybe one of the newer things in the game last 4 or 5 years, where the kids are actually trailing the play and taught to have that ball kicked out.
Well, you know, at our level, and, you know, and of course, the NBA and the international ball, you have the shot clock. That might be your best open shot. Hitting the fourth guy in. A lot of teams can get three players back. You get that fourth guy in into the play and kick it. And you know, you and I know, you know, everybody talks about a stretch four. Can you get a guy who can catch and shoot? And with the rise of international players and, you know, the professional leagues, that's what they do. They're looking for that fourth guy who can come and really hit it. And if you have somebody like that, that really stretches the defense out as the ball's being reversed, because you're stretching him out, what I call east to west, sideline to sideline.
Yeah, no question. It is coming from the McCabe Atlantic League. This is nice. We have teams that are actually executing and getting up. Shawnee's pressuring defense, but not up grabbing you and holding you. They're taking advantage. When you pick that ball up, they're up taking away every pass they can. Noel is trying to keep the ball on one side of the floor. Shawnee probably does that better than any team I've seen, where they try to keep you on one side of the floor.
Well, you know I'm biased because Joe Kessler sent me a great player in Billy Kurtz. He's all South Jersey in football and basketball. I'm lucky enough to get him. And I didn't have to teach him a thing. So, I mean, it's a lost art. When a guy picks up the ball, get all over him, and you mirror the ball and force that next pass to be a soft pass, a lob pass, a bounce pass. You know, and it's they really have done a great job, and I agree with you. It's a great point. They've kept the ball on one side of the floor.
Yeah.
It helps defensively.
No question. Well, let's talk about your team. How are you guys doing this year?
Good. You know, we have, of course, every year we have the South Jersey flavor. You know, Flo De Silva's a junior point guard from Bishop Eustis. Had a great career so far. He's been a three-year starter for us. Brennan Crawford, sophomore from Camden Catholic, just was named Small College Player of the Week by Hoop Group. He's been averaging 17 and 10, so he's really come on as a sophomore, and both of them are outstanding in the classroom, which is probably more important than anything that we do on the court. That's what's really important. So, I mean, we're led by two South Jersey guys, as we have been in the past. You know, we've really lived off the good coaching and good playing in South Jersey. You know, you go back to T. John Cassiello, who graduated last year in Wildwood Catholic. He's in Letterkenny, Donegal, for Victory Scholar. He's in grad school full-time, getting that paid for and playing professionally. Although a little different in Ireland, you know, they did have one game, and the one guy, McGregor, had a fight, so they had to cancel it because all the players wanted to watch the fight. But you know, T. John's doing well. For the people to remember T. John from Wildwood Catholic, and again, you know, Dave DeWeese did a great job with him, coaching him, of course, in the high school level.
Sure. Now, people don't know if they know much about the sciences, but if not, it's Division II basketball, and people don't understand how good basketball Division II is.
Yeah, you know, the national template for Division II is transfers. You know, of course, not at our place, but you have a lot of guys that start at D1 schools, end up playing at D2 programs. That's just a template and the way things shake out in our level. You know, the basketball is very, very good. Again, I come here, I had Eric Canalosi, who, you know, won a state title here for Camden Catholic. Matt Crawford, the coach, was NAIA All-American for me when I first became the head coach after 18 years as an assistant. So, I mean, the level of basketball is very, very good. And, you know, and those guys, you know, again, you know what? There might be something to a kid staying local.
Yeah, no, right? I agree. Heck, all my kids, they travel too far. As a parent, you want to have them at least a little close, especially playing sports.
Yeah, it's a good point.
It makes it nice to get to the games.
Well, you know what? One of the things that we sell, of course, because of the academics and the job opportunities, is you get to share your career with your friends and family, you know, if you stay local. You know, and I, you know, just look at Rowan and Stockton, South Jersey. I mean, they're two terrific programs. you know, I could go on and on with small college. I mean, it's very good level, and people should get out and support it. I mean, it's a good night out of basketball.
I agree, and then you can get a half a good meal there in Philly too. So after the game,
you got Tony Luke's. You know, what I mean, my favorite little chicken cutlet with some greens, because I'm biased, so I can't eat cheesesteaks anymore. I'm too old for that. But you know, it just and again, it's a nice thing. I mean, we don't charge. I mean, many small colleges don't charge. I mean, you know, you're not paying for parking. You're not paying to get in the game. You know, you get a hot dog and a soda for a dollar or two. It's a good deal. Mm-hmm. Plus, you get to see a kid that you've seen in high school or maybe played against or know about, see them continue their career. You know, and again, the other thing is, with us, all the South Jersey guys come back and support the current South Jersey players.
Yeah, no, that's great. I mean, and I know I sent a couple kids to Holy Family, and
sure.
And there's, it's just good basketball.
That didn't help me, by the way, sending them to Holy Family.
We took a tour with the one.
I know. You did a great job with them. They, you know, they went to a great program there.
Yeah, no, and it's worked out for them, and people hear all Division II, and they think, oh, well, that's not quite as good. They're fantastic athletes, fantastic coaches, great facilities, great education. I'm a little biased because I did play Division II.
Yeah, I just want to say one thing. When you graduate, it doesn't say NCAA Division I, Division II, or Division III on your degree, okay? So it's all relative. I mean, do you have an education? Do you have the job opportunity? Do you have a network of friends, your college friends? And also, you know, do you have lifelong friends?
Yep.
You know, they won't tell about the score, but it's those relationships. It's not about the buildings. You know, it's about the people.
Yeah, no, I agree. Well, Dave, thank you very much.
Oh, great to see you, man. It's a lot easier here watching
on
the bench, right?
I haven't gotten a technical yet, so it's a step in the right direction.
Well, let's see if it gets a little close to the second half. Thanks for having me, everybody.
Yep. Tony, that's Dave Pauly. He's been heck around South Jersey recruiting and coaching for all my 30 years down here. And a guy that you could talk basketball with for days if we needed to do that.
Yeah, he's quite a character.
Yeah.
Knows his stuff, and a great personality as well. Just to briefly go over the scoring before we start the second half. This is unofficial, of course. Not too much to talk about as far as Camden Catholic is concerned. Dominic Dunn with 1 point. Ian McCarthy with five. For Shawnee, they're led by Sean Heim with 14. Dean Knoll with 12. He's been on fire. Kane Fodner with 5 points, and Devon Robinson with four. 35-6. We are just about set for the start of this second half, and I guess you got to start from ground zero, because what are you going to do? You can't make it all up in one possession.
Yeah, you got to take it one possession at a time. I know everyone, it sounds like a cliche, but just try to win the quarter. Try maybe to split the quarter into 2 or 4 minute sets. I'm sure Coach Crawford has given them a goal as they get out there. They really didn't play that poorly. The ball didn't go in the basket, and Shawnee shot the heck out of the ball.
So inbounding from right in front of our broadcast location will be Sean Hein. Watched by McCarthy. Comes to Knoll, who kind of took over the last 2-3 minutes of that second quarter.
He had a big smile on his face to start the half. I can understand why.
Devente outside. Returns to Knoll. Knoll, Devente, Robinson, Kernan, and Hein. Jumper is no good. Rebound comes off to Cooney. Same starters that began this game for Camden Catholic. Deep along the left sideline. The long-range jumper is no good by McCarthy. Rims out, and that's the kind of game it's been for Camden Catholic.
Yeah, that's a good shot.
Here's Devente. Left sideline for Kernan. Looking to penetrate with a step and the scoop. It is good. And he was fouled on the play. Pretty move there by Kernan as he is able to scoop that ball under the arm of the defender. He got it to go, and the foul.
And I believe he's a sophomore, and you can just see them thinking the game as they're making plays. They're just so well coached. And the experiences they have growing up through their AAU and the JKMB and everything they have is these kids are quality high school players as they come in when they're young.
And Kernan with his first 3 points of the ball game, that makes it a 32-point advantage for Shawnee. Left sideline, Cooney. Down low it goes to Ajike. Ajike is double teamed. Ball deflected, tapped, taken by Cooney.
free throw line. Left side, Dunn loose for the jumper that is good.
He had those looks in the first half, too. They're going to have to hit some of them to make a run here because Shawnee's not going to make it easy.
38-9. Moving it across in deliberate fashion is Knoll. Watched by Streeter up high for Robinson. Hits the cutter down the lane for the reverse that is no good, and that is Kernan again. So he's getting involved now in the offense is Kernan. Not too much in the first half. Didn't score, but now two trips down, he's touched.
Yeah, now Cam McCaffrey's going to try to overplay a little bit, and now they're going to get all the cutting and screening from Shawnee. Like there's a little post entry, a back cut there by Kernan, and they go and able to get the opportunity in the lane.
Free throw is good. So quickly, 4 points for Kernan here in this second half. After going scoreless in the first, second also good. And he has a very sweet stroke on the free throw line.
Yeah, that looked good coming out of his hand, didn't it?
49, that's 42-9. Let me make that clear. Right sideline. Cooney has it poked away and out of bounds. Last touch, though, by Shawnee, that being Knoll.
This Olympic conference is so tough. You can have a division leader coming in and just run into a buzzsaw like this tonight.
Inbound pass to Dunn. Outside for Cooney. Thought about it. Does not let it go to the left sideline. Off to McCarthy to the baseline with a step. Outside, here's a GK with a short jumper, and that's what they want to do with the GK right there.
Yeah, you would think. He's got to score most of his points in the lane.
40-11. Knoll, cross court for Kernan. Left side. Watched by Cooney. Outside, nearly deflected and stolen, but captured by Knoll. Underneath now, Devaney cuts in and lays it home. So the good look, and Devaney's got some size at 6'6", but also some bulk to go with it.
Yeah, he fumbled the ball, didn't panic, kept his feet under him and finished.
Cooney with a step down the lane. Cross court for GK and lays it in, and he was fouled on the play. So if they can get him going, that's going to give him some hope, no question.
Yeah, I don't think they're really doing anything different here in the second half. Just a matter of balls going in the basket.
GK getting frustrated there at the end of the first half of play, but here, getting into the flows, checking in is Rob McCoy, placing McCarthy for Camden Catholic. A GK, no good, rebound taken off by Knoll. Remember, a GK is just a sophomore at 6'5".
Yeah, you like having your sophomore have a little fire to him. You don't want him to do anything that would get him in any trouble, but the fact that they're down, you want to see him to have some fight.
Devaney outside for Hine. Left side for Kernan. Down low for Robinson. Backing his way. Now pushed by a GK. You could see that one.
Yeah. Yeah, well, he's outweighed, I think, there about 25, 30 pounds there in the post. So he was trying to get any little push he could.
Yeah, the 6'4 Robinson against the 6'5 at GK. Maybe even 6'6 at GK. Sitting down is Dunn. Coming on is Nichols. They're going much smaller here.
Yeah, they definitely are. It looks like they're trying to get a little quicker, maybe pressure a little bit more.
Kernan, right-hand corner. The long-range jumper is good. One more time by Knoll.
I'll tell you, if you don't like the Shawnee guards, then you don't like basketball. These three are playing a heck of a game right now.
Tremendous shooting by Shawnee. They now lead it 45-13. Right side. McCoy, cross-court pass. Finds Cooney for Nichols. Right side of the circle, returns to Cooney, swings it left sideline for Streeter. Puts on the floor with a step underneath to McCoy, but does not have a look outside. Nichols for the long-range jumper. Looks to get his own rebound, but knocks it out of bounds.
Yeah, that one was deep. He almost had to fight Coach Crawford's position on that one when he thought that, let that one go. Yeah, I thought they might go to some pressure. Shawnee's tough, though.
Hine will toss in, comes to Robinson, returns to Hine. Hine will break the pressure. One hops right side for Kernan. Kernan works against a GK with a step. Left side, Devaney, loose for the jumper that is good. And when you're 6'6", center, so to speak, is popping them like that, you know it's your night.
Well, Noel made a basket cut that made the entire weak side of the defense come in the lane, and it opened up Devaney on the wing. But, yeah, you're right. I don't know what you can do about that one.
Down low. Cooney with a jumper, no good. Should say for the drive, no good. And they get the rebound and right back the other way. But was that out of bounds?
Yeah, Devaney lost it out of bounds. I think he was trying to rip down the rim there on that one and forgot to bring the ball with him.
48-13. Shawnee. They led it 35-6 at halftime. Here's Streeter. Right side for the long-range jumper by Nichols that is no good. Saved to Knoll. Knoll down the lane. Scoops and hits.
What a tremendous decision. No one stopped the ball. He just kept going, and then he finished.
Yeah, but he decides that he's going to the 10. He just does it with authority.
These guards are juniors and sophomores. They're all back next year.
50-13. A GK to McCoy. Left side for Streeter. Watched by Kernan. For Nichols. Center court, Cooney. Snaps right side of GK. Has room. Cuts to his left. Short jump is good.
He was playing under control. They kind of flattened down and allowed him to get into the lane.
50-15. With a step was Knoll, but he was fouled on his trip. He's another guy that's got to get in front of him. Stay in front of him.
Yeah, I'm wondering if that's the last we're not going to see of Heim and Knoll tonight.
Fuchner checks in. As does Stefan for Shawnee. Kernan right side of the lane. The jumper is no good. Now the rebound comes off to McCoy. Leaves it for Nichols to the forecourt. Sends right side for McCoy. Right-hand corner for a GK. Puts on the floor. Outside for Cooney. Deals right baseline for a GK. Short jump again. So he's getting into a little bit of a rhythm here.
Yeah, it seems like they've gone to a lot less movement and just trying to clear side for a GK.
Ball knocked out of bounds. Last touched by Camden Catholic. 2:14 left in the third. Inbound pass to Robinson. Robinson accelerates. Robinson outside for Stefan and poked away, and Stefan then commits the personal.
Yeah, see, those are the mistakes that the starting guard, Shawnee, didn't make. That one dribble there, and he gets stripped. There's no reason to take one dribble. He could easily have swung the ball like Shawnee was doing most of the first half. But it's an inexperienced guard to come in. I'm sure Coach Kessler will let him know. And he'll learn the Shawnee way sooner or later, that's for sure.
Dunn checks back in, as does McCarthy for Shawnee. Nichols to Cooney. Left side. One hops up high for Dunn. Here's McCarthy. Cross the lane and a whistle. Foul. On Shawnee. Non-shooting affair. Third team foul for the Renegades. Inbounding is Cooney, but it's stolen by Robinson.
I was just about to say, Shawnee's defense seems it's relaxed a little bit, and then they jump in a passing lane and get a steal.
Kernan up high for Robinson, deep in the left-hand corner for the jumper. That is good again by Devaney.
Well, Robinson's the only one that hasn't hit a three tonight, I think, out of the starters.
Yeah, I mean, Devaney is 6'6". He's a junior. And a whistle.
It's an illegal
foul.
Screen on GK.
So we walk the length. Non-shooting affair again. Checking back in is McCoy, pardon me.
We're not in the penalty yet.
Right. Yeah, you're right. Inbound pass to Kernan. Double teamed to the backcourt. To Stefan. To Devaney. Underneath Robinson all alone. Easy bucket. Drives and hits.
Now Stefan kept the ball off the floor that time. Turn to hit opposite, and Shawnee gets a layup on the other side.
55-17. Left sideline. Streaker. Outside, here's Cooney. The jumper is good.
There aren't a lot of easy ones for Camden Catholic. That was contested right there, too.
Stefan. Fuchner. Up court. Down the lane for Kernan. No good. And the follow, as you can see, is wedged between the backboard and the hoop.
Yeah, I think Robinson and Devaney were fighting each other for that rebound.
55-19. 43.8 seconds remaining in this third quarter. As Cooney just lets it roll, give himself a little bit more time. Snaps right side for Dunn. Returns for Cooney with a step down the lane. Left-hand scoop is no good. Just didn't have enough on it. And a whistle. Is it G-King?
Yeah, I think he came in over the back. Devaney there to help defense again to make that shot. It was going to be a tough left-handed finish.
Yeah. Just couldn't get it in close enough above the hoop. It was too far to the left for it to have a shot. A second personal on a G-K.
Seeing a little half-court trap here out of Camden Catholic.
Cross-court pass from Kernan for Fuchner. Tapped away. Last touch, though, by Camden Catholic. Likelihood with just 21 seconds left in this third quarter. They'll hold for one, but, of course, they don't look like they're going to. It's Robinson.
Not tonight.
Laying it home. He doesn't really have to. McCarthy has it poked away by Robinson. Right side.
Robinson's an athletic kid for his size. He's definitely going to help Shawnee as they try to progress in the state playoffs. They'll need that body and that athleticism, that's for sure.
Back in is Dunn for Camden Catholic. Cooney with the inbound pass to Dunn for the jumper that is in and out. And a rebound is taken off by Robinson. Robinson at 6'4", can handle as well. Let's fly, but too late.
I was about to say, that's pretty good ball skills he's showing there, too. So he's just not a body that's running up and down the floor. There's a lot to be impressed of with Shawnee, no question about it. And I got to tell you, Camden Catholic is having a tough night, no question about it. But they've got a good, solid team here of young kids. So they've got a lot to work with, and the season's still young.
Insurance can be very complicated, as you know. How much do you need? What kind is best? At Mutual of Omaha, they simplify the process. Mutual of Omaha can help you decide on the best life insurance or Medicare supplement insurance for your situation. Also help with disability insurance, online banking, and retirement plans. Contact the professionals at Mutual of Omaha, 9000 Lincoln Drive, East in Marlton. They can be reached at 856-988-7771. That's Mutual of Omaha, as we're just about set to begin the quarter.
Yeah, I don't think we have any starters left on the floor for Shawnee.
Some scores. Eastern on a final on top of Woodrow Wilson, 82-75. Camden beats Lenape, 49-48. We'll get to some more in just a moment. Fuchner, left-hand corner. The jumper, no good, but would not have counted. Sam McNellis let fly.
I got to tell you, every night in the Olympic Conference, you can find a game like Camden-Lenape that would just be fantastic to watch. Coach Qatar does a great job there in a one-point game.
Streeter. Down low it goes to Dunn, but it has it poked away and stolen, but then retaken by Streeter to the cutting McCoy, who banks it home.
The Camden Catholic's still playing hard.
Washington Township 41, Timber Creek 34 in the third. Get to some more in just a moment. Fuchner underneath has it poked away, looking for McNellis. Last touch by Camden Catholic.
Yeah, I'm sure Coach Kessler's going to get someone in the middle against this half-court trap.
Willingboro knocks off Medford Tech 83-77. Nichols cross-court pass to Fuchner outside. He finds Devaney, this one being Connor. Deals for Stefan. The long-range jumper is no good by Devaney. Rebound taken off by Camden Catholic. It's poked out of bounds as Dunn to the forecourt. Willingboro, as we said, Medford Tech, they beat them 83-77. Cherokee leads Cherry Hill West in the third, 31-20. Here's McCoy. Leaves it for Streeter. Streeter, center court. For Dunn. Falls down. Leaves it for Ajiki underneath. Can't make it go, but gets his own rebound, and he'll shoot two. Some other scores. Woodbury leaves Haddonfield 27-17 at the half as well. Ajiki's first is no good. And by the way, Sean Hine is Shawnee's top three-point shooter, as if we couldn't figure that out.
I think a blind man could have done that.
He had 16 made threes coming into this game, and we thank Dee Bukowski for that information. The second is good, but lane violation, it will not count.
That Haddonfield game's an interesting game. I believe they're undefeated. That would be an interesting final to find out.
Checking in is Corbett, Patrick Corbett for Camden Catholic.
Here's this half-court trap again, and number 20 splashed to the high post. I think here.
And then he right side for Fuchner, who's down the lane for the scoop, but it's good. Check that, Stefan, pardon me, not Fuchner. Right sideline of GK. Cuts to his left, sends left sideline for Streeter. The jumper is no good. Rebound loose on the floor, picked up by McCoy. One hops to a GK right baseline. No good, but he's run into and fouled.
Kind of has a different release on his jump shot there. He doesn't really follow through and hold it. He kind of flicks it, and that made it a different kind of challenge for the Shawnee player. He wasn't expecting that type of release, I don't think.
Drew Brennan getting set to report in for Shawnee. Delay here is some conversation.
I think it's the fifth foul on number 14. 14.
Fuchner.
Yeah, I'll let you say that name.
It says four up on the board, so I don't know.
Yeah, now it's,
oh, now it's
up to five.
First is good by a GK.
I don't think we've called him Baba once tonight. We've stayed with the GK.
That's it. Babatunde is his first name. And the second is also good. So after a quiet first half, he's come on to score 10 in the second half. It's 59-23 with just over 6 minutes left in this ballgame. Right-hand corner, the pump fake and the long jump by Brennan is no good. And the rebound comes off to McCoy. To Streeter. Streeter to the forecourt. Right-hand corner for the jumper that is no good, and a whistle.
A GK with the offensive board and the finish. Shawnee was reaching down low. These last couple misses by Shawnee and three-point line is lowering the percentage. They might be down to 70% from the three-point line tonight.
It's a shame. 5:43 left in the ball game. 59-25, Shawnee in total control. Well, it's known all over the Delaware Valley, Johnson's Popcorn on the Ocean City Boardwalk, specializing in their delicious caramel corn. You can get Johnson's Popcorn in individual servings, all the way up to 3.5-gallon tins. Look for them in your favorite food market or party store. Johnson's Popcorn at 1368 Boardwalk in Ocean City. Phone 800-842-2676 and have your popcorn shipped to you. We're also online at johnsonspopcorn.com. Johnson's Popcorn since 1940. Both teams back on the court. And a GK at the free throw line. Chance for the three-point play. And he gets it. 59-26. Deveni up court finds Brennan underneath to the cutter that is no good. That was Stefan, just couldn't get it to go. Had an easy win and a great look as well.
Yeah, that was great basketball.
A long-range jumper left side by Streeter that is no good, and the rebound taken by Stefan.
Yeah, Sean, he's keeping the ball off the floor against this pressure, making Camden Catholic chase the ball in the air.
McNellis, a long-range jumper right side by Deveni is no good. The rebound comes off to Camden Catholic as we approach 5 minutes left in the ballgame. Right side, McCoy. Outside, Ajike for the long-range jump. Kind of out of his range, but why not?
Yeah, it was a flat release, but I think as he gets a little older and starts elevating, he'll get a little arc on that ball, and he's going to be a good player.
Brennan, cross-court sends for Stephan. Returns to Brennan. Back to Stephan, left side. Long left sideline, it's Deventi. Cross-court for Brennan to Nichols. Down low for the short bank. That is good.
That's how you teach it. That's how you break pressure and attack a point zone.
Barcino. Right sideline. Streeter. Right side, he finds Corbett. Up high for Streeter. Right side. They work it around. Here's McCoy.
Camden Catholic running their flex offense.
Corbett for Streeter. Streeter behind the back. A little dangerous there in the traffic. Outside sends for Corbett. Corbett with a step down the lane. Banks it home. 61-28. 3:42. Left in the ball game, Fuchner. Guaracino, center court for Deventi. Guaracino, right-hand corner for Nichols. Outside for Deventi. Down low. Passes errant, looking for Stephan, but he wasn't really looking for it.
No, that's one of the few possessions lately that they didn't attack the zone with a high post. And because of it, it made it a difficult pass, and it didn't end up where he wanted it, I'm sure.
Dunn is back in, replacing Streeter. Here's Corbett, veering right, pulls up for the jump, no good. Ajike with a follow that is good, and again he was fouled on the play.
Well, he hasn't stopped playing hard, that's for sure.
And another three-point attempt the traditional way for Ajike. He's a 6'5 sophomore.
That was a good-looking shot for Corbett, too. He dribbled hard with his dominant hand, pulled up straight, just wasn't able to pull that shoulder over to get the hand in the middle.
Dunn will take a seat, replaced by Feliciano. And he hits. So GK seems to be a pretty good free throw shooter. The inbound pass is stolen. McCoy for the reverse. That is no good. Gets his rebound. The follow no good. A GK follows no good. And again, a GK fouled as he is dominating underneath now. And will shoot a pair.
Yeah, I think Camden Catholic's on the floor with four sophomores and one junior now. So the young kids are getting in and playing hard. Oh, Shawnee has their bench in also.
So Ajike again, unofficially with 17 now.
Yeah, he had a couple good post opportunities early in the game that who knows if they go in, what kind of difference that makes.
And the second also good. Well, this evening it was kind of like everything went as well as it could for Shawnee, and everything went about as bad as it could in the first half for Camden Catholic, and what are you going to do, right?
Yeah, I remember years ago when I was playing my team down in Florida after the game, I told them, you guys shut me up. You played the best game you could possibly play. That first half was a thing of beauty for Shawnee. I'm sure Coach Kessler was very happy.
So moving it across is Brennan. Gives off to Ryan Hine. Right sideline to Brennan, looking to fire down low for Hine, but off his fingertips, the last touch by Camden Catholic. So a lot of brothers playing in these games.
Yeah, I saw Devaney come in. I'm sure Coach hopes he gets as big as his older brother, that's for sure.
I'm sure. Here's Brennan along the left sideline. Swing it right side for Hine. Outside for McNellis. Brennan. Left baseline for Hine for the jumper. That is
good, it runs in the family.
I wouldn't think it'd be fair to put two of them on the court at the same time.
Center court, Wolfram. Outside, McCoy, let's fly. No good. And a whistle. A hold against Shawnee.
I think that's J.C. Dobis.
Okay. First was good.
And Coach Ketchum before the game says the meat of his schedule is coming up, so I'm sure he's happy that he's able to get his kids some rest. I would probably think they might have a game Saturday or early next week. So I'm sure he's hoping that they can keep playing the way they're playing.
Second was no good. Now loose on the floor, Feliciano. To Corbett, right side. The fadeaway is no good, and the rebound is taken off by Shawnee. McNellis to the forecourt. 140 left to Brennan along the right sideline. To McNellis, underneath to the cutter that is no good. That was Hine. Rebound comes off to Camden Catholic. Feliciano looking to fire underneath. Has it poked away, but then recovered by McCoy. Here's Feliciano. The long range jump is good for three. 64-37. Just over a minute left. Here's Hine. Switching hands on the dribble to Brennan. Underneath to the cutter. That is good for McNellis.
Nice look. Shawnee's kids dribble second. So that way they see the floor and see the openings, and that makes the game a whole lot easier, no question about it.
Think that McNellis may have a contact problem, so comes out of the game.
I think Devaney's coming back in for him, the younger Devaney.
Yeah.
Wonder if Robinson's not on the bench saying, I'm the only starter that didn't hit a three, can you let me get back in?
Dobis down the lane for the floater that is no good by Corbett. The rebound taken off by Brennan with just 40 seconds left. Brennan backing his way. Cross-court pass for Hine, outside for Devaney. Down the lane for the floater. That is good by Brennan. McCoy outside for Wolfram from distance, way off. Here's McCoy with the rebound underneath to the cutter. That's Dobis, no good, but he was fouled on the play. So just 12 seconds left, and after the game, we'll be talking with Joe Kessler, the victorious coach of Shawnee. So stay tuned for that. Dobis at the free throw line will be shooting. Here's the first. It is good.
It's a good looking release from the kid. He's another sophomore. So Camden Catholic's got a lot to look forward to in the future. Sometimes it's hard to shake these kind of games off, but they've had a good year so far and a lot of big games ahead of them.
Second is also good. 68-39. Devaney just holding the basketball. And that's it. 68-39 is the final. Shawnee really took control of this game in the first quarter. They led it 14-1 and then 35-6 at halftime. After three quarters, they were on top 57-19 and finish up winning it 68-39. So they improved to 12-0, and Camden Catholic falls to 8-3 on the season. I don't think there was anybody who really expected this kind of an outcome for this game between two very good teams.
I think you got to be real happy with that first half. I know from me watching, you're fantastic.
They are. The good thing about this team is they play well together. They like each other on and off the court. You could see that they share the ball. They play good defense, and it's a pleasure to coach these kids.
I got to tell you, Noel over here to start the second half had the biggest grin on his face, and it was fun just to watch him play. You could almost see him thinking the game, the one break. It's a 3-on-2 break. They didn't stop the ball, and he just kept going. I really enjoyed watching them.
He is, and it seems like right now everybody plays their role. And, I mean, he's quick. He gets to the basket. We got outside shooters. And, you know, when they have to guard the outside shooters, it just opens up the lane for him, and he goes. He's got a good motor.
He does. I said it almost looked like he was borderline out of control, but he wasn't. He was going so fast, but still able to make good decisions. And in the second half, Devaney stretching the floor a little bit. Has he hit those shots consistently?
He does. He's a very good three. I mean, he's our leading scorer, and you figure we played the whole second quarter without him. And he's tough. He's got good moves, but also can shoot the three.
Now, I was sitting there saying, was Robinson bugging you on the bench? He's the only starter not to hit a three in the game. Did he want to get back in at the end?
Believe it or not, he has our best three-point shooting average.
Oh, yeah?
He does. But, he wants to be outside, but you can see he can do damage inside.
Yeah. Well, Joe, I'll let you get in there. I got to tell you, good luck with Atlantic City. If you run into him down the line, hopefully you get there. I'd like to see that one.
Yeah, thank you.
All right, good luck.
All right, thanks very much. George McNally talking it over with someone who he's very familiar with as a fellow coach, and also now doing the radio, in this case television, online version of this game. And I tell you, I don't think anyone thought this was going to be the result here tonight.
No, I thought we were going to have a good, tight game. You could see in warm-ups, I thought Shawnee was probably a little bit more physically gifted. But I would never have guessed how those Shawnee's guards played tonight. That was a lot of fun to watch. Even though it wasn't the closest game, those three really played well. I know Hine probably didn't get a shot. I don't think he took a shot. No, he took 1-3 in the corner early in the third quarter. But it was a lot of fun, and I got to tell you, there's some good Group 4 teams out there. The state Group 4 playoffs are going to be a lot of fun, real competitive games. Lenape, like you said, right there with Camden, and they're well-coached. Cherokee always plays hard. Atlantic City coming in there. I mean, the team, Southern Regional is usually one of the top teams. They're going to struggle even to get in the Group 4 playoffs this year. So there's a lot of good basketball yet to come, that's for sure.
Well, I'll tell you, I don't think I've seen it. A more impressive performance by a team in a long time. I mean, that just technically, the way they played the game and the way they executed the game was almost to perfection. They're probably going to go on sjsportstalk.com and watch this thing and say, see, that's the way we want to play. And if they can play like that, I mean, they're going to be a tough out.
Well, the interesting thing for me with Coach Kessler, he said they like playing with each other. And absolutely that was evident in what they do. Every shot that was taken, the kids were all in good spots. They were making the extra pass. If something didn't happen right, they were picking the other up. The Shawnee team, I don't think, has been number one in Group 4 for a few years, if not a little bit more. But, man, they're a deserving Group 1, number one seed right now.
Oh, there's no question about it. And as they say, and as a coach, I'm sure you always preach this to the kids, whether it be high school, college, or pro, you're never as good as you look, and you're never as bad as you look, especially with these two teams. I mean, they're going to take it. It was a blowout win, no question about it. They led it 35-6 at the half, but I don't think they are 30 points better than Camden Catholic, even though they looked that tonight.
Yeah, I agree. And for Camden Catholic, they got some good opportunities. They executed pretty well in the first half. They didn't go. I mean, that breakaway, you could almost see the body language when the kid missed the breakaway and it rimmed out. They had a tough time even bouncing back from that, because I think that might have been still like a 10-12-point game in that area. That gets in there, make another shot. I thought Ajike got a good couple opportunities inside, and they ran some nice things on the perimeter to get some three-point shots that they knocked down a few in the second half, but not any in the first half.
If you take a look at the box score, you're going to say Ajike had a really good game with 18 points, but most of that came after Shawnee had put in their subs. As far as Shawnee is concerned, Dean Knoll led the way with 17 points. Hine with 14 points. The rest of them chipped in as well. Devaney with 8, a couple of big threes as well. Robinson with 7 points. But I think kind of Dean Knoll was the face of the team here tonight just by the way he played, not only offensively but defensively as well. He's so valuable to the team.
Yeah, every facet of the game. And I thought another interesting thing from Coach Kessler, Devaney's their leading scorer. I would not have guessed that. And watching Howard, to think Hine was getting as many shots up as he could, and then you say Knoll. And even Kernan, that's a good young player. I was really impressed with him. So their first five, I think, can play with anyone.
Yeah.
Now you see certain teams have a little bit more depth, and that's certainly what Atlantic City will try to do. Atlantic City will try to get into their bench, whether it's getting a full court or through foul trouble or whatever that would be. So that'll be interesting. That the old days of the Shawnee Atlantic City Group 4 finals in Atlantic City, I went to a couple of them. They were a lot of fun to see. It'd be fun to see that again, that's for sure.
No question about it. And you know as well as I do that Atlantic City likes to pressure. Maybe not the entire game, but their thinking is if we pressure by the time fourth quarter rolls around, we're going to have worn down the opposition. But the way they play, Shawnee, they have a good ability to break the press, and they take advantage of what you do defensively. And they're tough, they're aggressive, and it would be, as you said, a very tough matchup, very good matchup.
Yeah, and with Atlantic City, they like to do a lot of side-to-side dribbling. And the way Knoll and Shawnee defends, trying to keep the ball on one side of the floor, you're going strength on strength. You know, now that I got some time, there's some games that I would definitely like to see. Hopefully Shawnee, Atlantic City, somewhere, that would be a game to see.
Well, right now in South Jersey, Atlantic City at 7-3, and South Jersey 4 is ranked number 7. Shawnee right behind them at 11-0 is ranked number 8. Interesting, they improved now to 12-0. And of course, Captain Catholic, as we said, ranked number 13. So once again, the final score, Shawnee, in convincing fashion, knocks off Camden Catholic by the final of 68-39. For George McNally, Mike Wolverton, on the video, and our producer, we want to thank you all. Dean Mikowski, thank you for the scores. And once again, the final here from Camden Catholic, 68-39. For George and Mike, this is Tony. Hope you enjoyed it. So long for now.